So I have been asked quite a few times if I would maybe talk about being a Catholic YouTuber, and I am definitely feeling God is calling me to do this video. Even if it's for one person out there, I am willing to do it. So this is all going to be about how to be a Catholic YouTuber and kind of why to do it. So pretty much, long story short, the way that I started being a Catholic YouTuber is I felt God was calling me to do it. And the reason, so what happened was I went to the Catholic church that I live near to ask them if I could start a mommy's group, like a Bible study or Catholic book club or something, and was like pretty much turned down flat. Like no ifs, ands, or buts, no questions. And the lady even said, she's like, oh yeah, a lot of people have been asking for that, but no, we don't really have the space for that, which the church has lots of space, and I think that's baloney. I don't think that's true. But I was like really sad because that was something I wanted to do and to give to God. So I just felt kind of deflated. I said, God, what do you want me to do? Like, I don't know. I really do want to do something, but I don't know what to do. And so I felt God silent, you know, very quietly say in my heart, like, start a YouTube channel. And at first I was like, what? Like, I know nothing about YouTube. I barely watched any YouTube, to be honest. And I just, like, didn't understand you. I didn't know how to make a movie. I didn't know how to download a movie. Didn't know how to make a thumbnail. Like nothing. I didn't understand the YouTube world at all. So I was like, okay, you know, and so it's funny because I always have this in my head where Mother Teresa talks about how God wants us to be faithful. He doesn't necessarily want us to succeed. You know, and sometimes, and that's true, and sometimes it's out of humility. He wants us to, you know, do things, maybe fail, but out of humility, and that's okay. Like, and so I just assumed that was what he was asking me to do. Like, so out of obedience, I said, okay, I will start a YouTube channel. You know, I asked my husband first, of course, and he agreed to it, and so, I'm like, okay, I know nothing about it, you know, so I started on my iPhone, and I still use my iPhone to this day, and I started, you know, almost immediately, actually, God gave me this zeal for doing YouTube and stuff, so that was, like, surprising to me, and it hasn't even been a year yet since I started YouTube and stuff, but anyway, so that was me, and I'm here to give you hope because I literally knew nothing about YouTube. Like, didn't understand how it worked. Obviously, I knew how to watch a video, but I didn't watch many videos. I didn't know what to do. So I, like, looked up Catholic Mom, and there was, like, nothing. Not any that were regular and current and that sort of thing. So I was like, huh, that's so crazy because there's so many bloggers, there's so many book writers, there's so many speakers out there, but no, like, hardly any Catholic mommy YouTubers that I could find, you know, and stuff. So I was like, huh, okay. And so I started, if you look back at my old videos, they're funny. they're fine. Like, they're good. I feel like the Holy Spirit was using me, but I definitely was not, I'm still not very good at it, but it's just one of those things where I'm like, oh, I say a lot, and I didn't know how to edit or anything, so I think you can see me, like, turning on and off the video and stuff, so I had to get it right in one shot. It was pretty funny, and, you know, and that's probably a good point. Like, well, first of all, let's set YouTube on fire with awesome, good, holy content. That's what I feel like God wants me to portray to you today. Like, go out there, set the world on fire, because there are people who are very visual and need to watch something like TV or, you know, that they can watch and hear. There are people, readers, and that's why where book writers and bloggers come in. You know, there's different people who learn differently. And so YouTube is one way that some people learn, you know. And so just keep that in mind. And you might be saying, well, Heather, like, what do I have to offer? Well, if you are absolutely in love with God and you then start, you like, for me, I felt like I didn't know much and I felt inadequate as well, but I knew I loved God. I knew that that's what I loved. And then I feel like you just find like another niche. So for me, that was being a homemaker and a wife. Like, those are the things I love. I am passionate about them. And so I was like, oh, I guess I could talk about, you know, motherhood or like C-sections and, you know, talk about God while talking about them and stuff. And so maybe there's something, maybe you love cooking. Maybe you could do a cooking show and talk about God while you're cooking and teaching people new recipes. Maybe you know how to build a car, like you could teach people how to build a car. And so bring God into that. Like, you know, maybe like God might be asking you to do something like this. Maybe you are passionate about NFP. You know how fertility works. You are really good at it. You understand it. I just did an NFP video and people want to know about NFP, let me tell you. But my whole point is, find your niche. What is your niche? What are you good at? And then go off of that and talk about God. Maybe you love history. You're great history. Maybe you can, so talk about history in the Catholic Church. Maybe you're a great storyteller and you love history. Like, people want to know awesome, good, holy Catholic stories. My one thing is, if you're going to be a Catholic YouTuber, then be Catholic. Please, please, please follow the teachings of the Catholic Church. That is the main thing. And I'm going to tell you that you'll probably get criticized for that. Like, what, being Catholic in today's world is a crazy thing. Like, you know, we are living in a world where if you follow the teachings of the church, don't use, you know, artificial birth control, you are crazy. Like, you know, there's things, you know, and you'll get criticized on both sides. I will say, like, I did an NFP video and there were people who were like, if you do NFP, you're doing a mortal sin, you are going to hell if you teach it. So there's people who are like way far to one side. And on the other side, there's people who are like, you do NFP, like, you're so old school, welcome to, you know, this century, like, you know. So you get, be prepared to be criticized about anything, you know. And if you think about it, Jesus was criticized too. Like, no matter who you are, you're gonna be criticized. So just keep that in mind if you do a YouTube channel. Now, I will say I prepared mentally for a lot more criticism than I've gotten, because I'm like, I'm going to be faithful to the church. And I know people are not going to be all about that. And people have different views on what Catholics believe and stuff. Like, I just did a Lent video for kids. And, like, kind of the criticism about that, you're like, okay, I'm trying to help people grow closer to God with children. Like, you know, like, back up. Like, it's okay. Let's just take a minute, you know, and stuff. So just like the criticism, or like, you're not hardcore enough, or you're too soft, or, you know, what, like, too hardcore, not, you know. So be faithful to God. You're not going to be perfect. Nobody is. Nobody's perfect. And the whole point is to love God, to spread the message of God's love to everybody, you know. And people gonna, you know, discriminate against you about that, that's fine, you know, and stuff. So, let's see. Oh, I would say if you do it, post at least weekly. You know, I don't know if I would post like 5 days a week. I know some people do that, but I feel like if you are constantly posting, then I don't know. Like, I feel like the magic might be gone, you know. So I feel like, when I first did it, I did like 3 videos a week because I was so passionate, excited about it. My kids were at a good age where I could video, do that many videos. Like, now it's just tough with 4 kids, but I still have that passion, but I just don't have the time to like prepare for them and all that. So I've kind of had to hone back a little bit, but I would say do at least one a week if you can, and try to keep that up. You know, maybe like for me, every Tuesday I do my videos, and you know, I go to adoration in the morning and ask God, what should I do? And then in that afternoon, I do the videos, you know, and stuff. So just something to kind of keep in mind, like try to do it at least weekly, because if people see one of your old videos, click on it, then they might go to your page and say, oh, when was the most recent video? And they see it was like three months ago. Then they might be like, oh, it's not worth subscribing, because I want to see somebody who's current and gonna share current things, you know. I would say, okay, so another thing is, don't be, like, if somebody already has the type of channel you're looking into doing, don't let that sway you. Like, if you want to be a Catholic mommy YouTuber, do it. For example, you have stories that I cannot share. You have different things to offer, to bring to the table that I can't. You know, like, I've had 4 C-sections. I talk about them, and that's something that some women could relate to. But say you're a mom who's had 3 natural births, you know, like, that's something that some women could relate to you about. So just keep that in mind. Like, just because I have a Catholic mommy YouTuber, you're like, oh, that one's already done. You have things to bring to the table that people might be able to relate to even more, if that makes sense. So some people might click on my video and be like, oh, okay, I like the video, but I don't really like her. Like, she annoys me. I can't handle her voice or whatever it is. That they might not, but then what if they see your video and they just click with you? So that's something to keep in mind. Like, what is it that I am passionate about? What's my niche? How can I relate to people? Because that's what, like, all social media is about, socializing, you know, relating to people. What is it that I can share with them that they're going to understand or want to grow closer to God with me through? So motherhood is what I'm passionate about, so that's why I started a mommy channel. But, you know, I do a lot of different things. You know, like I said, I did a video on my playroom. Like, I did a video on confession, how to pray the rosary. Like, all these different things that, they're all very different, but some people might connect to some things more than others. So anyway, I'm just saying that don't let, you know, like that Catholic couple, maybe you and your spouse are interested in doing a vlog. That's something that, you know, just because that Catholic couple is a great vlogger doesn't mean that you can't be it too. So just keep that in mind. Like, try to figure out, like, what is my niche? How can I relate to people and bring them into Christ, to closer to Christ? So I don't know if that makes sense. Let me look at my notes. Okay. Also, watch lots of YouTubes. Like, I knew nothing. I didn't know how to download a video. I didn't know anything. So I had to watch videos on how to download a YouTube video. I had to, how to edit on my iPhone. I didn't know how to do that. Like, how to make a thumbnail. I didn't know how to do that. You know, all these different things I've had to learn. And you're not going to be good at first. Nobody is. Like, if you are, then that's amazing. Like, you were meant to do this, but most people are not very good at first, and that's okay. Like, so maybe just, you know, before you buy any, like, you do not need expensive equipment. I have my iPhone. I still use that, and I also have, like, a ring light because it takes away the bags under my eyes pretty well, and so I like that. So I did invest in that. But that's about it. Like, there's not a whole lot that you need to do YouTube. It does take time to edit and to, you know, figure out what you're going to talk about and stuff. But don't go get crazy, you know, equipment until you've been doing it for a while and that you feel comfortable. I will say it is really awkward and weird when you first start talking to yourself in a camera. very, very weird. And I've finally warmed up to it, but it was a while. Like, it took me a while to warm up to talking, monologuing pretty much, and stuff. So keep that in mind. It's going to be awkward. It's going to be weird. Like, but everybody kind of starts from scratch. That's the only way you're going to get good at something, is by, you know, starting from scratch, you know, learn how to do it and see if God gave you that zeal. Because maybe that's what He's calling you to, is to start a YouTube channel, to reach out to people. Maybe you know, whatever it is. I mean, you know, what's your niche? What is it that you could bring people in closer to God? I would say try not to have videos that last super long. I try to do, even though this one's going to be long because I'm trying to talk about YouTube, trying to promote you to YouTube. But I would say try to do like 7 to 12 minutes, somewhere in there, even shorter, you know. But people usually have pretty short, you know, they can't watch a video for that long. So keep that in mind. Try to talk about something that you would be interested in, you know, and try to not talk monotone. Obviously be authentic to who you are, but, you know, try to be engaging to the person or, you know, whoever is watching, like you are two people just sitting there chatting, talking, best friends, you know, and stuff. Like, that is what you want. Like, you want that connection with people. And I love it. There are so many people who have said, I feel like we could be best friends. Like, you know, and I just, that's like the biggest compliment, because I just remember, anyway, I love it. That is the best compliment I could ever have, is by someone saying, I feel like we could be best friends. I feel a connection with you. And I think the hardest part on the other end is that, you know, YouTube, like, I don't know you guys. Like, that is the hardest part for me. That's why, like, I started the What's Up Christian, because I really wanted to connect with you guys. It's like, and some women have started a YouTube channel, they said, because of me, and that's so humbling, so awesome. And I love it, because then I get to connect to you guys, you know, like the What's Up Christian. That's so awesome. I got to connect with so many people and see their lives and get to know them. And I just, like, oh, there's nothing better than that. Like, that is the biggest, oh, I love it. So try to be connected, be engaging, you know, don't talk monotone, like, talk excited, passionate, also be authentic, but about what you're talking about. And just know that, yeah, there's going to be criticism. People, you're talking about Catholicism, that in today's world is a crazy thing. Like, talking about NFP, like, people just go crazy about that, and they just can't believe you don't use artificial birth control, and they think you're judging them because they use it, or whatever it is. Like, you're like, I'm gonna be faithful to the Catholic Church. So be faithful to the teachings of the Catholic Church. Be a good person, you know, spread the word of God. That's the whole point of this video here today, is let's set YouTube on fire for the love of God, and to just share what God has done in your life. You know, share your testimonies, be personal, like, talk to people like they are your best friend, get excited to be on camera, you know, all that stuff. So anyway, let me check my notes. See, stay true to God. Yes. Yeah, so I think that's most of it. If you have questions, definitely ask me. I love your guys' comments. Also, let me know if you are starting a Catholic YouTube channel. I would love to promote your channel. I might give you a couple months to kind of warm up and make sure you're, you know, get things going. I know for me, I didn't really tell any of my family or friends that I was on YouTube till I felt like I was comfortable enough, like, where I was like, okay, I'm starting to kind of understand the YouTube thing. And then I told people, because I just wanted to, like, kind of not perfect it, because you're never going to. And trust me, you're going to have videos where you're like, oh, why did I say that word? Or why did I say that? Or, you know, you tweak words that are, anyway, like, you just wish you would have said it differently. but you're never gonna get it perfect is what I've come to realize. There's not a single video where I'm like, oh, everything I said in that video was amazing. Just not gonna happen. So you just gotta give it all you got, do the best you can, and just ask God to take care of the rest. Like, God, this is all for you. Let me glorify you through this. So So let me know if you do start. I would love to watch your channel. You know, ask me questions, like anything that you want to know. Let's set YouTube on fire for God. Go Catholics. Like, let's do this. Let's just rock the YouTube world. All right. Until next time, I will see you all later. God bless. Bye.